We will begin our program. My name is Keisha Taylor. I am Second Vice President, Scholarship Coordinator, and Co-Chair of this Finer Womanhood Telethon.
My name is Donna Caldwell, and I am Co-Chair of this Finer Womanhood Telethon. The next voice that you will hear is our opening prayer by Janet Adams.
Good morning. Let's bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this gathering today. Lord, thank you for time to share with others. We understand our privilege to be here, and we pray to be a blessing to those we encounter. We know that when we gather together, virtual or in person, you, our Heavenly Father, always has a divine agenda. We thank you for the opportunity to praise your name again. We pray for every mind and heart that fills the presence of this event. Father God, we continue to ask you to protect us from the coronavirus. We pray that the vaccines are safe and will help. We pray for those who continue to work on the front line and our essential workers. We pray for our nation and the world to work for an end to the systematic racism that has prevailed for so long. We pray for the leaders who have power to bring about change. Lord, let them lean on you for wisdom and direction. We pray for peace in our communities. We pray for protection from the weather systems that have been continuous, and we pray for peace. Most gracious Father, we pray for your guidance. Lead us in your direction. Father God, you are our sustainer, our refuge, and our strength. Lord, we thank you and love you. All of this we ask in your precious and loving name. Amen.
Thank you, Sora Adams, for the prayer. Next, you will hear Soras Lynette Harris, Dawana Richardson, followed by our President Geneva C. Moody as she brings greetings.
Oh. Good morning. On behalf of our international president, Valerie Hollingsworth Baker, our Atlantic Regional Director, Gina Merritt Epps Esquire, our New Jersey State Director, Titisa D. Smith, and the ladies of Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, I greet you and welcome you to our Final Womanhood Telethon. Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated was founded on January 16, 1920, on the campus of Howard University in Washington, D.C., by our five girls who founded our illustrious sorority on the principles of scholarship, service, sisterhood, and final womanhood. For 101 years, Zeta has stood on these principles and continued our founder's vision of promoting scholarship. Thanks to your generous support, Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter has awarded over $10,000 of scholarship to deserving young women in Burlington County. In January, our nation witnessed history as Vice President Kamala Harris was sworn in as the first female Vice President of the United States of America. This historical moment allowed girls everywhere to realize all dreams are possible. Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter is committed to helping young women reach their dreams of achieving higher education. We thank you in advance for bidding on our silent auction baskets and your donations and helping us achieve our goals. Once again, welcome and thank you for joining us today and enjoy the program.
We have a wonderful program in store for you today, and it is especially blessed because of the many organizations and pillars of our communities that have graciously agreed to join us in our push for scholarship. Our next two guests are no strangers to good works. Please stand by for messages from Reverend Stacy E. Williams, pastor of Garden of Prayer Church, Pemberton, New Jersey, and Willenboro Township Mayor and founder of All Things Are Possible Foundation, Dr. Tiffany Worthy. And we would like to invite you, our viewing audience, to join us as well by giving the gift of education. Throughout this program, there will be multiple ways for you to help us to raise scholarship funds. And the biggest one is the donate button. So please push that button and donate.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, everybody. My name is Pastor Stacy E. Williams. I am the pastor of the Garden of Prayer Church in Pemberton, New Jersey. And I just want to say congratulations to Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, Madam President Geneva C. Moody on another stellar year of scholarship, service, sisterhood, and final womanhood. You all have continued to be a beacon of light as you continue to forge ahead with your grounding principles. I just want to say once again, congratulations on how you remain a constant resource, especially with your scholarship platform. You remain a light even in dark places, and the young people through our community have been blessed by your generosity and your constant presence. So I want to encourage you to continue to walk the path and be that example that is so needed in a world today. Listen, last year was a very difficult year, and I can truly say that one of my most precious moments was when I was honored to serve as your Woman of the Year. As a pastor, sometimes you have reservations about being connected with certain organizations, but I can tell you certainly it was not the case with you all. Your reputation preceded any formal introduction, and that was a reputation of being nothing but excellent. And I am proud to be connected with you all. And I just want to once again encourage you to continue to know that what you are doing is making a difference. Just know that God has made you in purpose for a purpose. So be about the purpose. God bless you. And know this, that greater is yet ahead of you. God bless you.
Greetings, Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, and to the ladies of Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, and greetings to Geneva Moody, President of the Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter. I'm Dr. Tiffany Worthy, Mayor of Willingboro Township. The ladies of Zeta Delta Zeta know the importance of working in the community with local leaders of nonprofit organizations, civic leaders, school administrators, and elected officials. Not only do they call on pillars of the community to assist with efforts, but they also diligently work to create partnerships to respond to challenges that require more than a quick fix or superficial effort. Thank you for your commitment to acknowledging the efforts and the impact that leaders make in the community. As a member of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated and the leader of a local nonprofit organization, All Things Are Possible Foundation, I truly appreciate that you proudly support all your Divine Nine sister sororities and their efforts for positive change. The Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter's largest community-inclusive incentive is their scholarship, where in recent years, they have awarded more than $15,000 annually in scholarship funds to female high school seniors pursuing degrees. Thank you, ladies of Zeta Delta Zeta, for your diligence in community service, scholarship, and for making a positive difference. It takes a village.
Good morning. Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, Geneva C. Moody, President. It is with great pleasure that I bring greetings and congratulations to the Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, from the Zeta Mihais of Morristown, New Jersey, on another year of celebration on your Finer Womanhood Luncheon. Your continued work and commitment is greatly appreciated. It is evident in your work as you continue to strive and keeping up with the vision of scholarships going forward, and for this, we salute you. The theme for 2021 Virtual Telethon, Pushing Through Today for Tomorrow's Scholars, will be exemplified in your works within your community service, programming, and fundraising efforts. This past year, we all have been made to deal with many obstacles, which it has made us realize that community service is the key to making a difference. We, the Zeta Mihais of Morristown, look forward to working together with the finer women of Zeta. Congratulations again. Thank you. Our president, Adele Dumas, Zeta Mihai of Morristown, New Jersey.
Good day. On behalf of our 35th International President, the Honorable Michael E. Crystal, our 27th Eastern Regional Director, the Honorable J.R. Reeves, and our New Jersey State Director, Brother David Moore, my name is Brother Ron Brewington, and I am currently the president of the Kappa Upsilon Sigma Chapter of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated. We are happy to be here today, albeit virtually, to support our sisters of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, as they host their annual Finer Womanhood Scholarship Luncheon and Fashion Show. I would like to thank the Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter President, Soror Geneva Moody, and the Finer Womanhood co-chairs, Soror Keisha Taylor and Soror Donna Caldwell, for allowing me to speak this morning on behalf of the Sigmas. We are looking forward to enjoying today's program, and we hope that you do the same, because it never disappoints. We are also looking forward to the day when we can all be together in person and enjoy once again in fellowship. Thank you very much.
Good morning. I bring you greetings on behalf of the 30 chapters, elected and appointed officers, youth, amici, and Zeta Mel Network auxiliaries in the state of New Jersey. Congratulations to the sorors of Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter on your inaugural Finer Womanhood Telethon and Awards Luncheon. This year's theme, Pushing Through Today for Tomorrow Scholars, reflects your continuous efforts to raise scholarship funds for the youth in Burlington County. Given the current climate with COVID-19, I applaud your efforts with programming and fundraising to ensure that our first principal scholarship continues to be highlighted. Congratulations to all of the honorees, as each of you exemplify individual and collective excellence in your service to the community. I want to give special recognition to the Zeta of the Year, Sir Caitlin West, who serves as the state webmistress and undergraduate co-coordinator. I would also like to acknowledge all of those who contributed to the success of this event, especially the co-chairpersons, Keisha Taylor and Donna Caldwell. I charge the president, Sir Geneva Moody, and the Sorors of Zeta Delta Zeta to continue Zeta's mission to serve to help other people excel. Thank you, and please enjoy the program.
Now you will be treated to our scholarship portion of the program. We'll have an HBCU salute video, Rep Your School, Acknowledge the Universities, represented by our chapter members, representation of ZDZ, Zeta Youth Auxiliaries, a scholarship spotlight, and finally, an interview with our Dove and prestigious National Scholarship Representative, Sir Catherine T. Malvern.
Ladies and gentlemen, DSU Band alumni, it is time. It was once said that we wake up in the morning with our mind set on marching. It was once said quality becomes quantity. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time. It was once said that one hornet can sting you, but a swarm can be deadly. It was once said that it don't take many to do.
Thank you. drum majors, the Fabulous Five, the Five Horsemen. Frederick, you wish.
Work, hailing all the way from Queens, New York, by way of Woolenboro, New Jersey. It is my honor to serve at the 74th Miss Morgan State University. I am an Ebony HBCU queen in community engagement. Morgan prepares diverse and competitive graduates for success in a global interdependent society. My platform is DNA, and the purpose of my platform is to encourage students to be their authentic selves. Every student on my campus has distinctive qualities that define who they are. Those unique qualities can and will never be duplicated. My duty as Miss Morgan State University is to help them become familiar with those qualities and drive them into their destiny. I have used my platform as an Ebony HBCU queen to live my dream as being a servant leader. The work I do on my campus is not about me, nor is it about my sash or my crown. I live to improve the lives of others, to help people see the beauty in life's everyday struggles. I live to help people transform their childhood traumas to a living testimony of perseverance and destiny.
Congratulations to all of our amazing honorees. We hope you are enjoying this program today. What a great way to spend an afternoon helping fulfill the dreams of many bright young minds. Your donations today indeed may pave the way to educate the next Mary Maynard Daly, the first African-American woman to earn a PhD in chemistry, or Mae Jemison, celebrated astronaut and engineer, Lisette T. Treat Montgomery, renowned game developer, or hidden figure, Katherine Johnson, mathematician. Your contributions provide the means for tomorrow's STEM scholars. Make a donation today.
We'll be right back.
2020 was a year of uncertainty, but one thing for certain was that Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter would continue to support our local scholars in obtaining their goals through awarding scholarship funds. Our 2020 scholarship recipients are listed on our website and represented 6 different Burlington County high schools. 2 of our 2020 recipients, our first placed awardee Morgan Wormley and our former Arcanet Nia Dunn, want you to know how these scholarships have impacted their academic careers, and you'll hear from both of them via video. Another 2020 Book Award recipient, Jada Thomas, has written a gratitude letter and an update for us of her academic progress, which can also be viewed on the site today. Zeta Delta Zeta's 2021 scholarship application is open now through March 31st to high school students graduating in June 2021. Please see our website at www.zetadeltazeta.org for further requirements. We look forward to assisting the class of 2021 in their academic endeavors.
Hi, my name is Nia Dunn. I am the president of the Arcanets of the Zeta Phi Beta, Zeta Delta Zeta Youth Program in Burlington County. I would like to thank Zeta Phi Beta, Zeta Delta Zeta for selecting me for this scholarship. I've been a part of this program for a very long time, and I want to thank Ms. Wanda and Ms. Keisha and all the other sorors for mentoring me to be a finer woman. I will be using this money to further my education at Rowan University. I will be majoring in environmental science / zoology. Once again, I would like to say thank you to all of you.
Having this scholarship from Zeta Phi Beta Sorority has motivated me to work harder in my studies because I want to be academically successful to not only prove to myself but to others that I'm a deserving recipient of this scholarship. As well as this scholarship being extremely helpful to my family and I would like to be academically eligible to apply for and receive such an amazing scholarship like this one again.
Thank you, Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, for my scholarship back in 2012. I was awarded the Estelle Grace Scholarship, which was a $1,000 scholarship that was presented to me my senior year. It did help me tremendously in my time freshman year. And then when I decided to transfer in 2014, I reached out to your chapter, and you did hold your promise where you said that if I needed anything, you would help me, and you provided me with additional funding to go to the school of my choice. And then from there, I graduated from my master's program, and I reached back out because I wanted to join this amazing chapter, and now I can say I'm a part of Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter.
Standing on. into your love, into your light. Grace upon grace, beauty for ashes. You come to us, we come alive. We stand in awe of you.
And certainly not least, we bring our awards representing the community of Burlington County. Last voice you will hear in closing remarks from our president.
Exhale Women's Fellowship Incorporated, led by its executive director, Mrs. Cloud Clark, is a service organization in Burlington County which provides crisis intervention services to women in need. Exhale Women's Fellowship provides direct services to these women and works with other organizations to provide safety, emergency shelter, and assistance, mentoring, and career training. These programs strengthen and encourage these individual people to be self-sufficient. As Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated focuses its efforts on mental health, domestic violence, awareness, and women's empowerment, it gives us great pleasure to award Exhale Women's Fellowship Incorporated our 2021 Service Organization of the Year Award. Congratulations and continue doing the good works. You'll now see a short video acceptance from Exhale Women's Fellowship.
to President Geneva Moody, Keisha Taylor, Donna Caldwell, Sharon Howard, and all the members of Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority, Incorporated. On behalf of the Board of Directors and the members of Exhale Women's Fellowship, we enthusiastically accept this Service Organization of the Year First Responders Award. Because your organization is dedicated to scholarship, service, sisterhood, and finer womanhood, we're happy to be recognized by your organization that has such high principles. You lead the way in serving our community and partnering with us and other organizations. So thank you. Sharon Howard and this local chapter of Zeta Phi Beta partnered with us to distribute household and personal items to homeless people living in motels during this horrible COVID-19 pandemic. And you also supply protective equipment like hand sanitizers and face masks to keep our clients safe. Your state chapter supplied many items for our clients who are domestic violence victims. Sharon, you and Zeta Delta Zeta are in the trenches with us, helping to provide real help for real women. We can't thank you enough.
Our 2021 Woman of the Year recipient is a woman with purpose. She's driven, compassionate, and selfless with her giving. She's a virtuous woman, a true woman of God. Dawn Marie Hutton is the First Lady of Second Baptist Church of Mount Holly, New Jersey, where she serves with her husband, Reverend Dr. Timothy L. Hutton, Sr. Together, they are also community servant leaders, known for their philanthropy and entrepreneurship in Burlington County. In addition to her role as a devoted wife, her most cherished role is that of a mother. Dawn is a woman of integrity. She is strategic, forward-thinking, a woman who desires to see others reach their potential and rise to serve their communities. She is an inspiration to women and girls alike. It is our pleasure, a sincere honor, to present Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, 2021 Woman of the Year Award to Mrs. Dawn M. Hutton.
Greetings to the finer women of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, and Madam President Geneva C. Moody. My name is Dawn Hutton, and I serve alongside of my husband as a First Lady of the Second Baptist Church of Mount Holly, New Jersey, co-owner of T.L. Hutton Family and Friends Funeral Services of Burlington. It gives me great honor to be before you on today. Thank you for selecting me to receive your chapter's most prestigious award, the 2021 Women of the Year Award. My husband and I share in your vision and commitment as we have served our community for over 20 years. We have dedicated ourselves to giving scholarships and educational necessities to students furthering their education as they prepare for their future. What an honor. Let me begin by saying, I truly admire your organization's commitment to excellence in the area of service and scholarships. You have established a history of over 100 years sowing into the lives of our young people. As you continue to reach out to the community in your way of excellence and dedication and resilience, I applaud your history of Z Hope. Zeta's helping other people excel. What a mission. And you all, the phenomenal women of Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, are shining examples to our inspiring young ladies of today and tomorrow. Thank you again for the honor that you have given me and may God continue to bless your endeavors. Thank you.
Zeta Amici, also known as Friends of Zeta, are strong, determined, purpose-driven women whom wholeheartedly believe in and support the ideals of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority, Incorporated. Zeta Delta Zeta's Amici of Morristown, New Jersey, exemplify the meaning of outstanding community works, leadership, and sisterhood. Today, we honor all of the women of our Morristown Auxiliary with the Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter Amici of the Year Award. Thank you, Amici of Morristown, New Jersey, for all that you do.
Good morning. Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter. The Zeta Amici of Morristown, New Jersey, would like to thank the Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, for this Amici of the Year Award. This award is very meaningful as it strengthens our belief in providing community service and the chance to give something back to the community and to make a difference to people around us. Volunteerism goes beyond doing something without expecting anything in return. Volunteerism means serving in an area of need to gain a sense of purpose and just to become happier people and working with the Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated and rewarding enough. We, the Zeta Amici of Morristown, are honored to be receiving the Amici of the Year Award. Thank you from all the Zeta Amicis of Morristown, New Jersey.
Brother Ron Ace Brewington. As president of Kappa Upsilon Sigma Chapter, Brother Ace Brewington's commitment to the familial relationship of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated and Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated is exemplified by his willingness to cross the aisle, for lack of better terms. As you all know, the brother-sister relationship can sometimes get a little testy, especially if both are committed to excellence. Brother Ace is dedicated to community service, his fellow man, and fostering the best relationship between our chapters, which is exemplified by his involvement in Zeta Sigma relations and an ongoing communicative relationship with our president, Geneva Moody. Brother Ace gives Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter great pleasure to present you with the 2021 Sigma of the Year Award. Congratulations, brother. And we look forward to continued collaboration to uplift the Burlington County community, as well as continuing to uphold our constitutional bond. You know, the only, never mind, people don't know about it. You will now hear from Brother Ron Ace Brewington.
Thank you very much. First, I would like to thank the members of Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated for presenting me with this very prestigious honor. Being recognized as their Sigma of the Year is something that I will cherish for years to come. I would also like to thank the Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter President, Soror Geneva Moody, for being a great blue and white partner during both of our tenures as leaders of our respective chapters. I would like to thank Soror Angelica Russell for her partnership over the past few years as my principal contact for Zeta Delta Zeta in our Sigma Zeta Relations Committee. Working together with her and other ZDZ committee members have gone a long way in building the bond between our two chapters. I would like to thank the brothers of Kappa Upsilon Sigma Chapter for showing their faith for me to be the face of the chapter and the leader for the past 3 years. This is a great responsibility that I do not take lightly. Our elected e-board and our appointed members have made my life very easy as a leader. I'm a proud member of this fraternity and my chapter, And it is because of these bonds that I stand before you today. I am not a member of this fraternity to earn awards or accolades. I am a member of this fraternity to do what our founders instilled in each member. That is to serve our communities, be a positive role model, be a mentor to our youth, be a positive role model to our children, and also to respect the brotherhood and our sisters. Doing these things are all the accolades that I need. Being recognized as Sigma of the Year is very special, and it means that I have been the example that I have set for myself and more. Last but certainly not least, I would like to thank my family for being my support. My wife Donna, who has been the backbone and unquestioned rock. Without her support and understanding, it would be very difficult for me to do many of the things that I do, not only within the fraternity, but also in my professional life. My sister Karen, who has been my best friend throughout all of her life, being my younger sister. She has been there for me through very difficult times. We all live together, along with my daughter, Kiana, and her husband, Justin, and also their three children. They are the number one reason why I stand here today. Thank you again, Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter. I am very humbled, and this day is one that I will never forget.
Hello, it is my honor and privilege to present this year's Zeta of the Year Award to Sor Caitlin C. West, who also happens to be my niece. Sor Caitlin West was born in Atlanta, Georgia, and was born into quite the blue and white family, as her parents are both a Zeta and a Sigma, as well as many aunts, uncles, cousins. She grew up in Lumberton, New Jersey, and attended the Lumberton Public School Systems. She graduated from Rancocas Valley Regional High School in 2011. Upon graduation, she attended the College of New Jersey, where she studied sociology, Spanish, and women's gender and sexuality studies. She also obtained her master's degree in college student affairs from Rutgers University, New Brunswick. Professionally, Caitlin works in the field of higher education and student affairs. Currently, Caitlin is excited to be back at her alma mater, TC&J, working in the Office of Student Involvement as Coordinator of Fraternity and Sorority Life. She oversees all culturally based fraternities and sororities, professional organizations, and co-advises the Inter-Greek Council, which comprises of all 32 fraternities and sororities across campus. As a young girl, Sora West was a member of Zeta Youth Auxiliaries. She was initiated into Zeta Phi Beta Sorority by the way of Omicron Epsilon Chapter at TC&J in spring 2013. She has been a member of Zeta Delta Zeta since 2015. She is proud to have served on every level of the sorority since joining. Previously, she served as the Atlantic Regional Social Media Coordinator. On a national level, she currently serves on the National Mentorship Committee and National Public Relations Team. On the state level, Caitlin serves as the undergraduate co-coordinator as well as the web team lead. In Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, she is currently secretary and public relations team lead, as well as serves on many committees such as Finer Womanhood, Scholarship, Membership, Social Amenities, and Nominations. Sora West leads her life by the quote, "Leadership is not about a title or position, but is about action and example." She is grateful and humbled this honor is bestowed upon her and is looking forward to her continued service to Zeta for many years to come. it is my honor and privilege to congratulate Sor Caitlin C. West, our 2021 Zeta of the Year.
Greetings. First and foremost, I would like to thank my parents, my mom, Sor Deirdre West, and my dad, Brother Keith West, for setting the example and instilling the values of their respective organizations into me. I also thank all of my blue and white family members, my aunt, Sor Geneva Moody, who is my president and who I've had the pleasure of serving under, my grandmother, who was an amici, and of course, the many aunties, uncles, godbrothers, godsisters, and cousins who have all shown me what it means to care for my community, selflessly give to others, and to never tire in my efforts to serve my organization. It is truly special to be a legacy. Last but not least, I would like to thank my sorors of the Zeta Delta Zeta chapter for this honor. I am truly honored and humbled to be named Zeta of the Year, and I actually did not expect it. I live by the quote, "Leadership is not about a position or title, but action and example." And that is what I use to inform my work in Zeta. All of the things I do are never for recognition, but because I am passionate about our organization and seeing its continued growth. ZDZ, I have so many of you to thank for so many reasons, for pushing me to try new things and step out of my comfort zone, and for identifying the talents and skills that I have that sometimes I don't see in myself. It is because of you all that I have been able to serve on every level of our sorority, and I look forward to continuing to serve for many years to come. Thank you all for being great examples of finer women and setting the expectation of what it means to be a hardworking, well-informed Zeta. I have been watching many of you do this work since I was a member of our youth auxiliaries, and it has inspired me to this day. This award will serve as a constant reminder to be the Zeta who works hard, blazes paths, and sets the example for others to follow. Thank you.
What an amazing program. Today we honor the extraordinary works of very special people who each have made an impact on our community through service. Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, Zeta Delta Zeta Chapter, continues to be guided by their principles of scholarship and service. As we celebrate 61 years of this scholarship program, we ask for your continued support in helping us grow the scholarship fund to reduce the burden of college expenses. Together, pushing through today for tomorrow's scholar. Please donate today.
Good morning. Thank you again for joining us for our annual Finer Womanhood Scholarship event. As we continue to push through today for tomorrow's scholars, we ask that you continue to bid on our wide selection of finer auction baskets by visiting ZDZ2021FWL.giftsmart.com or texting ZDZFWL2021 to 76278. This information can also be found in the chat. Bidding will close at the conclusion of our program. Winners will be notified at that time as well as where to pick up your baskets. So please support Zeta Delta Zeta's Scholarship Telethon today.
Thank you again for joining us on our Finer Womanhood Telethon. It is still not too late for you to donate and help make a young lady's life in Broughton County's dreams of attending college come true. Today would not have been possible without our wonderful committee under direction of Sor Donna Caldwell and Sor Keisha Taylor. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next year.